Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about common problems and reliability of Chrysler's 5.9 Magnum V8 engine. The 5.9 Magnum, which is also known as the Magnum 360, was released in 1993 and was used all the way up until 2003 when it was replaced by the 5.7 Hemi, which is still in use today. The engine was manufactured by Chrysler, but was used predominantly in Dodge applications, as well as the Jeep Grand Cherokee. With respect to Dodge, it was used in the Dodge Dakota, the Dodge Ram, the Durango, the Ram Charger, and then some of their Sprinter vans. These engines have one main problem that we'll get to discussing, but outside of that one problem, they are generally very reliable engines that should pretty easily be able to make it to the 350,000 plus mile mark. But with that being said, there are a few drawbacks to this engine. The 5.9 Magnum doesn't particularly have the strongest reputation out there for being a favorable engine, but the primary reason behind that is because, one, it doesn't produce that much power, especially relative to some of the engines that Ford and GM were producing at the time. And secondly, it got very bad gas mileage. A lot of these applications with the 5.9 Magnum get around 11 to 13 miles per gallon. And so you get low mile per gallon with a V8 engine that produces 230 to 250 horsepower. So they are slightly underpowered. They don't get great gas mileage, but the pro to them is that they are reliable, they are durable, and they can last a very long time. That main problem that I was talking about was issues with the cylinder heads, but before we get there, let's go ahead and talk about one other problem which commonly leads to issues with the cylinder heads. So the first problem on our common problems list is going to be with the intake manifold gasket, or the Plenum gasket as it's frequently called. The intake manifolds on the 5.9 Magnum are actually a two-piece design. There's a top piece and a bottom piece with an intake Plenum gasket that sits in the middle of it. These intake Plenum gaskets commonly fail, which creates an air leak and causes the engine to lose some vacuum pressure. While a gasket leak and an air leak isn't a huge issue in itself, the problem is that a lot of times these Plenum gasket leaks tend to go unnoticed. And what happens is as those go unnoticed, you end up clogging up your catalytic converters because that throws the air-to-fuel ratios off, and your engine starts dumping more fuel into the cylinders, which then gets sent into the catalytic converters and causes them to clog up. And then as your catalytic converters clog up, that then causes your engine temperatures to increase, which leads to your cylinder heads cracking. Now, the cylinder heads are very sensitive to excessive heat, and so they do crack naturally, but the Plenum gasket failure is one of the common things that ultimately leads to the cylinder heads cracking. But it also leads to your catalytic converter failing, which can be an expensive replacement. While a gasket leak is not a big deal if you catch it early enough on, if you don't catch it early enough on, you could be looking at a new catalytic converter as well as new cylinder heads. And that takes us into our second problem with these engines, which is probably the most common problem on them and the one that's most worthy of talking about, and that's the cylinder head cracks. As I mentioned, these engines don't handle heat very well, and you end up ultimately developing hairline cracks along the cylinder heads. There has been an estimate from a shop out there that does a lot of work on the 5.9 Magnums that over 50% of these engines end up having cracked cylinder heads at some point. But the good news to all of this is that the cracked cylinder heads usually aren't a very big problem. They don't tend to lead to a lot of other issues. There's a lot of cases where you can drive around on them for years and tens of thousands of miles without any issues, but they can become problematic if you develop larger cracks and the cracks continue to expand. That's when you can start running into some issues with engine compression and internal components and things like that. So in most cases, it doesn't lead to anything major, but it certainly can. So it is important to catch this early on and make sure that you replace the cylinder heads. And the good news with that is that this is such a common problem that there are dozens of very affordable aftermarket replacement cylinder heads out there that fix all of the cracking issues. If you're looking at a 5.9 Magnum today, there's a pretty good chance it cracked a cylinder head at one point and probably has some aftermarket replacement ones on there that are a lot stronger. So overall, this is the main problem on these engines, but it's really not one that gives me a whole lot of concern or takes away from the overall reliability and durability of these engines. The third common problem on our list is issues with the timing chain. Now, this might be a little bit more of a maintenance issue just because timing chains do eventually need to be serviced and replaced, but the timing chain on the 5.9 Magnum does tend to start stretching around the 100 to 150,000 mile mark. And so it is a good idea to inspect and replace your timing chain every approximately 100, 150,000 miles, just to prevent your timing from getting thrown off, from jumping gears and potentially leading to more catastrophic engine problems with significant gear jumps that cause your internal components to collide with each other. Overall, just a maintenance item to be aware of that you need to stay on top of servicing your timing chain. And if you do so, that makes this not so much of a huge problem. One of the biggest things that causes timing chain failure is infrequent oil changes. So stay on top of your oil changes. And when you do service your timing chain, there are some upgraded timing chain options out there that will have way longer service lives with a lower likelihood of stretching and jumping teeth. So those are really the only three issues that are worthwhile mentioning for the 5.9 Magnum with respect to the engine itself. There are two other things that I wanted to discuss that are less related to the engines and more so the vehicles that these engines came with. And the first is the front end of the Dodge Ram trucks. The front end of these trucks are notoriously known to be weak, and the 5.9 Magnum is a large and heavy engine, and so it does accelerate the wear on the front end components. So your U-joints, ball joints, tie rods, wheel bearings, basically anything with respect to your front suspension and front drivetrain are going to probably need replacement a little bit sooner just because of the Dodge Rams having a weak front end to begin with and the size of these engines. And then the second thing is the 46RE and 46RH transmissions. These transmissions are what I would say shoddy at best. They typically end up needing rebuilds at about the 150,000 mile mark. And so the transmissions that come alongside the 5.9 Magnum are not great. They're not very reliable and ultimately lead to some repairs a little bit sooner than you would hope for a transmission. But all that to say, these aren't problems with the 5.9 Magnum itself, but rather the applications that they come in. So overall, with some new Plenum gaskets in there, with some aftermarket cylinder heads and staying on top of oil changes and timing chain maintenance, these are very reliable engines. Like I mentioned, you should be able to get 350 plus thousand miles out of them before you start running into any serious mechanical issues, so long as you take care of them with frequent oil changes and frequent maintenance. Now, I did mention a few negatives of the trucks that they come in, but the engines are great. You just need to keep in mind, if you're looking at some of these Dodge applications, to keep an eye on all of your front end components as well as the transmission. Anyways, guys, that covers it for our video on problems and reliability with Dodge and Jeep's 5.9 Magnum. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for all of our future Dodge, Ram, and Jeep content.